Hold everything while we hold this lever, the handy implement we use in one form or another many times a day. You even see it in a bar, and that is really what a lever is, a bar. There are three kinds, and they all need a fulcrum or pivot to work them. In the first class is the lever with the fulcrum in the middle, like the familiar seesaw. By moving the fulcrum nearer the weight, the girl can lift many times her own weight, and aren't the boys having a good time? In the second class, the fulcrum's at one end and the power at the other, with the weight here. Such an arrangement makes it possible for our girl to support at least three rough men. The purpose of the types you've seen is to gain power. The third class gains speed and distance at the expense of power. The human arm is a good example of the third class, though the arm itself, as I'm sure you'll agree, is definitely in the first class. Of course, you'd never have noticed the elbow action of a man about to have a quick one, but it's something like this. To lift 2 pounds, the biceps, in other words the power, must exert a pressure of 12 pounds on the arm bone. When you mention levers, you think of their first cousins, the gears. So let's visit the Kensington Science Museum for a glimpse of some of the very old gears, like the ancient mangle type. It turned a circular movement into a to and from motion, and a pair of horns guided a small wheel inside and out. This old fellow is operated by a nipping lever, as it's called, and the speed of the movement can be altered by adjusting the length of the crank, like so. It seems a thankless job all the same. An example of the use of friction instead of a toothed wheel. The large disc has a groove on the rim, and it's moved by a gripping action instead of a nipping one. In this model, 2 cone pulleys are coupled by a belt, and they form a speed gear capable of many variations. A screw carries the belt from one side to the other, and the gear changes as the belt moves across. And here's a type that's specially dedicated to our girl. A gear for a deer. No, I'm not romancing. It's actually a heart-shaped machine of the last century. In those purpley passionate days, they said it not only with flowers, but with gears.